We're now joined by the great Alex Stone, who is in Melbourne, Florida right now, watching very closely to see what's going to be going on with Dorian over the next several hours. And Alex is with us here on the KTSA Stevens Roofing Newsmaker Hotline. Good morning, Alex.
Hey, Trey, good morning to you. And right now, it really is, it sounds cliche, but a waiting game here in Brevard County. Like most of Florida, they've got to wait in the next 24 hours or so. Dorian is expected to pass by ever so closely here, just off the coast. But if the forecast track is wrong at all, well, then it could be a totally different ball game. And it's been wrong with this storm, as this storm has been so unpredictable. So people have been evacuated. They've boarded up. Stores are closed. And even if it doesn't come on shore, they're going to get walloped here by hurricane force winds on the left side of the storm as it's passing north. So they are getting ready. This guy evacuating from his mobile home.
It's spooky at all. The tension here is just all in the air. It's everywhere.
This is under this area a hurricane warning today. Many of the airports in Florida are closed. Orlando shut down a couple of hours ago. Daytona Beach, Melbourne, they're all shut down. And now we wait for Dorian to get off of the Bahamas, where it's been for 48 hours, and to begin making that move north.
Any idea, Alex, how long those airports are going to be closed? Do we even know? Have they said?
No, they don't know. It's all going to depend on the speed of this storm and the damage that there is or isn't after it's gone by. And a lot of the damage may end up being flooding. That's a major concern, especially along the coastal areas, where flooding is, like in Jacksonville, a problem even in minor storms, but this one likely to be a Category 3 as it passes by in the next day or so. But if there is any other damage, there might be wind damage, they would have to take care of that. But the main reason why they're shutting down, especially in Orlando, which is more inland, is for the safety of the flights coming in and out, and they won't reopen until it is safe again, hopefully by maybe tomorrow night they can get operations going again, or Thursday, but they just don't know.
And Disney World also closed early because they were wanting people to get out and move on about their lives. So 3 o'clock in the afternoon is the closing time at Disney World. So a lot of this stuff is, contingent on whether this thing is going to wobble one way or the other. And forecasters, as you've already said in your report, forecasters just don't know. They expect it to stay well offshore. But even with doing that, you know how those bands are, and they can be a big, big player inside of Florida itself.
Absolutely. And even if it is up to 50 miles offshore, hurricane force winds are stretching beyond that, and tropical storm force winds are looking at 120 miles out from the center. So this area is going to deal with likely hurricane, definitely tropical storm force winds, and then the flooding potential. Here along the water, the storm, especially as it moves north, and because it's going counterclockwise, you get that upper left-hand side, that pushes water in. The good news is the bottom side of that pulls it back out, but the damage may already be done. And then with how much force does it pull it back out? And those are the areas that they're concerned about here of being inundated with water. Now, there's a hope that we get through it in the next 24 hours, and they say, well, that wasn't that bad, and people get to go back to their homes, but they're being careful. Hospitals have been evacuated. Nursing homes have been evacuated because lessons have been learned in Hurricane Katrina, Matthew, Irma, all of these storms, that if you don't do that, well, then there can be a major price to pay. So they're ready, and now we wait.
Thank you, Alex. Appreciate your report this morning.
You got it. Thanks, Rick.